and welcome to CopTubeAmerica.com, where we teach you the elements of criminal law. I'd like to thank you, those who are teenagers, ages 13 to 17. How are you doing today? I hope you're doing fine. I hope that you are writing down words that you do not know the meaning to or how to spell, so you can get through some of this. Now, everyone's not up to speed when it comes to their vocabulary. So I want to make sure that you guys do just a little bit of homework. It ain't gonna hurt you. Get a little book and write down words like vandalism. Know the meaning of vandalism. Now, vandalism, the meaning you will find in the dictionary, does not give you the elements. That's my job, to teach you the elements. All right? Now, what are elements? They are these things that make up this thing. These elements are written by wonderful men and women that the United States of America has put in position, has hired, and yes, they do pay them. Some people back in the old days used to just volunteer. And they write laws to stop people from hurting or taking or destroying or removing property or people. Okay? You can't hurt someone. You can't maim someone. You can't kill someone. You can't take a person from point A to point B. You can't take a person out of their house unwillingly and put them in your house. You cannot do that. That's why we have wonderful men and women who have taken out time in their lives to write laws. Fairness is their task and their ticket for the day. Fairness. Okay? You can't do it, guys. All right? The laws are here to protect you, me, them, us, we. Okay? Get with your English. But get a little book, and you can get it for 99 cents, and write down these words. You'll be surprised when you look up 25 years from now, or when you hit age 25, for example, you're going to say, well, my goodness, I sure have learned a lot. I didn't know a lot when I was 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I had to look up all these words. And some people don't. Some people kept along with their words. Some people have the fortune of having a mother who is a lawyer or a dad who is a lawyer or somewhere in the legal system. And they pretty much heard these words and the definitions of these words as they were growing up. That's fortunate to them. Like some people are tall. And they do well at sports because they look for tall people, especially tall people who are willing to do what? Lift a little bit of weights. I told y'all about that weight room. That's a wonderful place to be. If you're frustrated, feel alone, baffled, confused, I don't care. Take it out on the weights. I bet you the weights won't put up with it. Bam! All right now, weights ain't gonna put up with your stuff and nobody else's. You tell that weight, blah, 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 blah. I bet you I know what that weight gonna say back to you. Do that. They ain't gonna say nothing. Lift me here. That's what that weight gonna say. Yeah, you wanna mess with me? Lift me here and lift me several times. I'm not going nowhere. I'm not doing nothing. I ain't gotta say one word to you. The weights will go like this. You talking that junk to me? Yes, they will. Okay? They are silent communicators. All right? So, let's get on with our subject for today. And we're moving right along. And the tapes are getting a little bit shorter. And yet they're going to... Because these are subjects that are pretty well known to society. Such as vandalism. It may have a hefty fine attached to it. They can be simple and felonious, okay? Now, if there are felonies attached to vandalism, that means the person did a whole lot. Oh, yeah. Believe you me, and the fine's going to go up, and the cost of court is going to be hefty, all right? Because they got to go through all that. Plus, they can be sued civilly. Wow. So you don't want to get into destruction of somebody else's property. Do you want somebody to destroy yours? No. No. You know what? When you're a little kid, here's a good example. A boy comes along, you have a little baby doll. And they take the baby doll's head off. Ah! Do you want your property destroyed? No. So don't go and be vengeful and take off your sister's, your little sister's baby doll head. Don't do that. Okay? Don't chop it off. Don't twist it off. Don't pull it off. Don't snap it off. Okay? So, people, we got to learn. We got to learn. And guys, you are wonderful students. Believe you me. Let me tell you, before we get into this hard and heavy, do not vandalize. Look up your words. Okay? Don't guess what vandalism is or vandalize. Okay? Or what a vandal is. Okay? You know what? There's nothing more beautiful than to hear a teenager who can speak so eloquently. I know I'm talking fast, but you guys, you know, y'all want to get outside, get on the computer, and I give you some breaks, okay? But listen, all right? Don't vandalize a school with graffiti, paint, throwing rocks and stuff, tearing up the building. I don't care if the school is abandoned or not. They know that that school is there. The school cannot be torn down until they get authorization from the school board. And the school board, more like, got to get authorization from the state, got to get authorization from the federal government, because they all put their money into that building. That is not, nobody can live, a homeless person cannot live up in a school that has been closed off. All right? You cannot vandalize a building that occupies people. It's up and running and the heat's going and the AC going. You can't vandalize a building that's just standing there. And it's ugly and it might be an eyesore. You cannot vandalize bridges with signs of I love you or gang signs. You cannot write on or tear up nothing. A side of a building. You can't go up there and vandalize a billboard. No. Stop it. You shouldn't be writing on the walls in your home. Okay? That might be for a lot of people where vandalism got started. All right? Now, vandalism has a lot with to deal with the destruction of something. You can't vandalize our highways. Okay? You can't remove trees. You can't cut your Christmas tree. You can't cut yourself a Christmas tree. You're destroying the trees. Okay? There's a lot of things you cannot do. All right? You can't go into the mall and vandalize the mall. You can't go downtown and vandalize. You can't vandalize anywhere. Nowhere. Don't even go to another country and vandalize. Ooh. That, you see, it does provide jobs. But it sure enough makes a place look very ugly. Okay? People have their perception of beauty. Hello? Hello? Alright? If you're upset and you want to get back at somebody, you can't tear up signs. You can't put Google Face on signs. No. You cannot. Woo! You can't key nobody's car. Talking about, because she don't love you no more. She dates somebody else. You caught him doing something. What? No! The insurance company get you. Most things are protected by insurance, and insurance companies don't want things vandalized. All right, let's get into our lesson. Come on, guys. You're getting ready to get to 18 and 16. Very important ages. You want to focus on your driver's license and getting your studies. But boy, you got to go into adulthood right. And I'm trying to get you there. Alright? Elements making up the crime of vandalism. One, the defendant maliciously defaced with graffiti or with other inscribed material or damaged or destroyed real or personal property. And the defendant did not own the property or own the property with someone else. Now, either you didn't own the property or you did. Now, it was my grandpa's land. I don't know. Did you own the property? It's my grandmother's house. But
did you own the property?
Were you only 13?
Did you own the property?
Well, it's my parents' stuff.
That's not yours.
Own the property with someone else. You have to be 18, sweethearts of the world, to own property. Okay?
Legal
property. Yes, you do. All right. 5 years to 25 years for this crime. Penalties, vandalism, damages that occurred and occurred, $1,000, and it will be going up. Now, you better be lucky if he gets you at $1,000, the judge, that is. Plus, cost of court, and they hate vandalism. All right, you can't vandalize buses or trains or the insides of them. Or if they just stand in there and look like they're abandoned. You know what? Pennsylvania Railroad, Amtrak know where their stuff is at. You can't go and destroy the train tracks, okay? So you see the train hop. There are people and stuff in those trains. You can't do that. All right, don't wait till you become an adult for somebody to teach you right from wrong or explain things to you. Look up some things on the internet. Watch what foolish people have done. You can't set something on fire. All right? No, you can't damage or destroy. It just doesn't have to deal with defacing with graffiti or other inscribed material. Okay? No. You can't chalk it. You can't. It's so sad. Some communities, the kids put chalk on the ground. You can't do that. Alright? If the cops show up, they'll be like, well, it was your neighbor. They tired of seeing the chalk and all the bicycles out here and everything. Well, it is defacing government property. The government owns the streets and the sidewalks. Alright? Now, they ask you to do it. Now have a hose and have some good old soap and get it off instead of just saying, no, I refuse to. No, or repeat when they told you not to do it again. $1,000. They have to clean up that stuff. All right, they have people going around in North Carolina. As soon as they see some graffiti come out, boom, here they go. It is gone. People in North Carolina, we report it and it is gone. Now, if you didn't get special permission, and you're going to need to get it from the city in most cases to put elaborate drawings, then you can't do it. Okay? It's real simple. Go and get yourself Etch-a-Sketch. And turn them little buttons to create there. You like creating, go get yourself your own little canvas. All right? But you can't damage or destroy anything. And you better make sure, when you get older, that you actually own that thing outright, then you can tear it up. You can't even tear up your own stuff. You didn't buy it half the time. Especially when you're 13. Where'd you get your money from? I earned it. You earned all that money for that big old computer. Sure did. Every dime. Every single. Where's your receipt? Have your receipt. Y'all got a lot to learn. Okay? Now, a conspiracy charge can be added to most crimes, which increase or may double your sentence. Someone said to me, what about that, the graffiti and all that goes on in New York City? Well, a lot of that stuff is allowed. Okay? A lot of it is allowed. Elaborate drawings. Ooh, they got some artists. But you have in Boston, Massachusetts, in New Jersey, let me see. You find some in Pittsburgh. Pennsylvania, a lot of it in Philadelphia, because there's a lot of artists there, okay? But you won't find it in more conservative towns. They just don't want all that. And some of the art just ain't no good. It's not beautiful. Mm. And then they go, now, let me tell you this. Don't deface a church. Okay? Don't do that. It upsets more people. If you know somebody done it, just call and have it removed. You need to paint over it or whatever. Okay? It's another thing where people just want to be heard. Alright? That's not... It's, come on. Come on. Alright. Let's act like we got good sense. Don't force yourself on people. You got, if you are feeling that creative, save up, buy a house, but you got to be careful because there's ordinances against painting your house some weird color, like hot pink with polka dots. But it doesn't go with the community. All right? But the inside of your house, hey, have at it with all the hot pink paint you want and all the dots, any color you want. And get down like James Brown and make it look good. Okay? All right. The inside of your house can be your entire canvas. Nobody can tell you what to do. Just keep the door shut. I'm only kidding. All right. So, but the outside, things that affect society, has an effect upon society, things that bring neighborhoods down, people don't have a right to do that because some people do it maliciously. They do it intentionally with all the evil integrity on this planet. Okay? They hate their neighbors, so they're going to paint the house lime green. They make the house glow in the dark. A nice neon color. Because the neighbor done made him mad. Ticked him off. And here they go. Is that graffiti? No. But boy, oh boy, oh boy, they're going to call it that. But that's just to say, if you are feeling your oats. And some people, you know, they love that, you know, hippie air. I do too. I love it. Okay? Can you, people tattoo themselves? Yes, but you can't tattoo another. You cannot be slick, even though we know it goes on. Come on, kids. And tattoo someone else's son or daughter. Putting graffiti on that child. You can't do it. You can't do it. Alright? Don't do it. Big brothers and sisters, don't do it. And don't tear up a campus. Okay? Don't destroy nothing. Don't get too creative and destroy a Rent America or any type Buddy's Rentals. They give out a lot of laptops, and here come people that are just defacing the property, and you can't pay for it, and they come and get their stuff. If the college gives you books and they're on loan, especially library books, do not destroy them. Do not deface them. Don't pull pages out of them. That's vandalism. Vandalism stretches wide. It really does, because it covers not just the defacing of something, but the destruction of something. All right? You can't alter it. You can't take your pen and vandalize the book. I don't care if you're doing it for notes. You can't do it. They pay a lot of money for those books to sit in libraries. That's a lot of money. Ooh, libraries are very expensive. Ooh, the cost of some original books and folks just taking their little highlighters and you can't do that. You can't rip pages out. Oh, no. No. You're like, what's the person all upset for? If you knew how much them books cost, if you knew what it took to get them books, and to establish those libraries, you would not be talking in the manner in which you speak. Would you want, if you did a book, would you want somebody, or you bought a book, would you want somebody else's crap in your book? Yes or no? Okay, then don't do it to anybody else. If you don't want nobody tearing up your stuff, don't you tear up nobody else's. Okay? It's real simple. And even if they do, don't go and seek revenge. Go to the courthouse. Okay? There are valuable pieces of art here. And some people will take a razor blade and they're going to get it. Don't go to a museum. It's been done. Don't do these things. Don't paint. Don't think it's funny. Don't laugh. Don't touch nothing. Don't knock over nothing. Don't break one vase on this earth. One glass. grandma's stuff, mommy's stuff, daddy's stuff, uncle, auntie's stuff. No. And don't mess with nobody's computer either. I'm trying to tell you all this for your own good. Before you get out here. Because if you destroy somebody's computer, they got all these notes and everything. Oh, wee. They're going to find value. All right, guys. Don't get started. All right. Let's keep their noses clean. Let this generation show everybody this is how you do it. This is how we do it. Another lesson down. We're going on to loitering. Lesson number 55. Officer Burnett is with you. 55. On lesson number 55. Moving right along. Wow. Only what? 45 more lessons to go. And we in. You in. Okay? All right. Be smart, guys. Don't get upset with your girlfriends. And girlfriends, we know we don't do these things. Don't be keying, of course. That's vandalism. You're going to be arrested. All right? Do push-ups. Go do sit-ups. Get a good ab. And every muscle is one guy that did you wrong. Look at it that way. All right? And guys, you do push-ups. Every muscle rippling is a woman that did me wrong. Over here is Janet. Over here is Shaquita. Over here is Karen. Right? And right here might be Mark. Every guy or girl that may have done you wrong. Okay. Let's move forward. Keep it light. See if we can do it right. Take your test. All right. Thank you, guys. All right. Bye. Let's keep going. I believe in you. Other people do, too. You got strength. All right. Bye.
The weight of my mistakes depends on how I feel. Don't let it bring you down. The weight of what I say depends on how you feel, but I don't.